welcome to another episode of Brad's Angling Adventures. Today, I'm going to go through a few floats and how to attach them to your line and stop them moving on your line. You've got, basically, to keep it simple, because there are a big number of floats out there on the market, do different things, but keeping it simple, you've got loaded floats, unloaded floats, straight float, straight waggler float, and an insert waggler float. Now, there are God knows how many types of floats out there. You know, you've got this one, which is a slider float. You've got this one, which is a dumpy feeder type waggler for sort of when you're surface fishing and that, or just fishing just, you know, slightly under the surface, more in the summer. You've got so many different types out there. But I want to keep it simple. So the ones I mainly use, to be honest, is these, either loaded or unloaded, and insert or straight. They're the main ones I use for 99% of my fishing, okay, if I'm float fishing. Loaded ones, some will be partly loaded, and they'll tell you on the float what's loaded and what else you need to put on your line. This one is a 1+2BB, so it's loaded with a BB there. Then you're going to want to put another 2BB or 2BB's worth of shot down your line. Obviously, your unloaded ones, some will tell you what it needs to cock the float, and then obviously you put some refining shot down the line. Other loaded floats come like this one, which is fully loaded, so you don't need anything else down your line. The only thing taking that out is that weight there, and obviously the weight of your hook bait. So that's mainly what I use. If you can hear my cat screaming her head off outside the door, that's because she wants to get in and help. She has to be in on everything, but I'm not letting her in because I'm talking to you guys. So how do we attach the floats to our line? Well, most simplest way is you've got your float, it's got a tiny little hole in the bottom of the float, okay? Pass your line through that hole, it's on, simple as that. But if the weather conditions change, or you want to fish further out than what this float and the amount of shot it takes is allowing you to, you're going to want to change your float. Now, the only way of changing that is by breaking everything down and starting again. So, what do we want to do? A couple of different ways you can do it. You can either use a simple rubber float adapter. You can use a normal sort of snap link swivel, or you can use one of this type of snap link swivel, which has got like a bead on the bottom of it, which will give your line a little bit of protection. More than this type will. So really, I wouldn't recommend using that type, but you can. Okay, let's talk about the rubber float adapter first. Very easy to use. Got a small hole in that end, as you can see, a few lines go through, and easy, as I say, to use. Just wet the end of your float where your float adapter is going to go onto. Just makes it a little bit easier to get on. And then just slide your float into it. Simple as that. Then, as you've done before with putting the float on the line, just put your line through the little hole on the bottom of the float adapter and it's on. Then, if you want to change your float, you simply take that one out and let's choose a different one. Let's go for this one. Wet your float again. Push it into the float adapter and you're fishing with a different float. As you can see, different size. This one's loaded, unloaded, straight waggler, insert waggler. Different way of fishing. Obviously, you're going to need to change your shotting according to what float you've been using and what float you're changing to. So that's your rubber float adapter. Next one is the swivel, normal swivel. Just put your float onto the swivel like so, and then onto your line. Easy as that. And then again, changing your float, undo your swivel, undo the snap link part of the swivel, take your float off, put your next float on, do your swivel up, float changed. Okay, that's that tight. But then, as I said, you know, you're not getting any sort of protection on your line with that, because it's just metal onto your line. And it's going to wear away at it over time. So I would rather use this type over that type. Works exactly the same way. You've got the snap link part at the top. Put your float on. Clip it in. And then put your line through the bead at the bottom. There you go, it's on. And same as before with the other one, just unclip it, take your float off, put your next float on. Clip it in and you're changed. Okay, without breaking everything down. So there's a few ways of attaching your float to your line. As I said, out of the three, I would either use that one with the bead or the rubber float adapter out of those three choices. Okay, so now, stopping your float, put my teeth in, stopping your float from moving on the line. A few different ways of doing that. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll use this one, the snap link. Put that on like that. Okay, now, if you're using a partially loaded float or unloaded float, you can use shot. shot here. So you've got that type, which you've got your triple A's, your BB's, your number ones, fours and sixes. Dinsmore's have actually bought out some shot that are BB's, ones, sixes, fours and eights. And they're very similar to Preston Innovations Stots, but they're in the bigger sizes, which I think are pretty good, to be honest. I like them, I use them. But I'll keep it nice and simple for you guys today. As I say, get your shot, whatever it is you need. I'm just going to use a couple of BB shot here because they're decent size for you to see. Get your shot, put it on your line. One there. And one there. Okay. That's either side of your float. Gonna stop it from moving up and down the line. Obviously, use the size of shot that you're gonna need for the type of float you're using. Just don't go slinging BB shot on every type of float because it ain't gonna work. But if, to be honest, using these type of shot, putting them on your line, they do damage your line slightly. And I find that they damage your line more than this style of shot, okay? So I've actually gone over to using the Dinsmore's gripper sticks rather than using your normal split shot. As I said, because I find them easier to use, and they don't seem to damage your line as much, to be honest. So that's why I've gone over to using them. But then, if you've got a float like this one, which is totally loaded and you don't need any other shot on your line, what you're going to need are these, which are like gripper stops, what they're called. Easy to put on, but you have to put some on before you put your type of float adapter that you're using on your line. What I normally do is I normally put a couple either side of the line. It just gives you that extra bit of security that it's not going to move. And all you do is they come on, little thing like that. They come in different colours. You can get black, you can get clear, all different ones. And all you do is, as you can see, they've got a loop on that piece of line. So I use these ones here first. You put your line through that loop, okay? And then just pull these up like so. Give your line a little bit of moisture. Just makes them go on a bit easier. And then just slide them off that loop onto your line. Just keep pulling them until they're on your line, like so. Okay, if you can see them. There you go, on your line. Then put your float on, as I've shown you. Then back to your gripper stops. Put your line through the loop. Double it back so it's like that. Get a bit of moisture. Push two gripper stops up that line onto your line, and then just keep them going until your line comes out like that, and then slide them up to your float. And there you go. They're between, your float's in between them stops, and it's not going anywhere. Okay, and then if you want to move your float up your line or down your line or whatever, remember, give a bit of moisture first, slide them up, and then slide your other ones up to meet it, and you've moved it. It's that simple. And you can do that with any of them float adapters that I've shown you today. And it's that simple, really. That's how you get your float on your line and stop it moving. So I hope this helps a few of you out there. Hope it makes it a bit simpler. And if you like the video, give it a thumbs up, and please don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you in the next one. So, tight lines.